prophet Isaac Mill, souls are falling to the place of torment because of disobedience. We know that the King Saul was rejected by God because of disobedience. Today people are ignoring the Lord warning that we have been delivering. They take God warning lightly. We must obey the Lord instruction and warning in order to see Him among us. We have been warning the world about women adornment. These beauty and makeup product are instrument of the enemy, and there is destruction in these apparel of the enemy. Nonetheless, many women don't take our warning about worldly adornment seriously, thinking we are just talking for the sake of it. The Lord has revealed that destiny and stars of many women are stolen when they go to salon to do their hair, and when you visit manicure-pedicure shop to paint your nail and do artificial nail. The people you give your head, feet and hand are stealing your blessing and stars. Many beautician and stylist company and saloon have entered in covenant with the devil, and these salon workers and aesthetic workers are stealing people's stars and destiny. We heard the confession of a former beautician who was an agent of Satan. God's servant must be prudent and avoid attending saloon to get these nails and these artificial hair, for these wigs are covenant with the marine world. Many of industry that deal with manicure, pedicure, woman beauty are of the enemy. Women give their feet, hand and head to be touched by people that are agent, servant of Satan have invaded hair saloon. There are satanic hair saloon of agents of darkness where they capture women's star. When they touch women eyes to place eyelash, when they paint women nails with nail polisher, and when they do wig on the head of women, they steal good things that the Lord has placed in their lives. Ladies must be careful with people who do their hair. These agents take the hair of women, artificial hair and deceased people. I remember a sister that went to the saloon to get her hair done. However, the hairdresser was an agent of the enemy. The sister failed to understand that we cannot give our head just to anyone. Not long after attending the saloon, she began to suffer migraine that was intense, for this agent of Satan stole her star and everything the Lord placed in her head. Over time she lost her life. She heard the warning about wig and artificial hair, but she thought we were playing. Another sister came to confess to me after ignoring and scolding my warning about wigs, makeup and worldly adornment. She said, "I thought it was just simple talk. It was not that serious. I did not take you seriously, but there was things happening in the spirit world. The Lord is sending His servant to warn His people to repent. And the devil is also sending his servant to precipitate the multitude of souls to the place of torment to torture them." When I began to warn women about makeup and adornment, my wife thought that I was just talking. She ignored the Lord warning and continued to wear wigs and artificial hair, until she saw in a dream that she was in a cemetery, where a dead woman sitting a coffin grabbed her wig. The deceased lady was pulling her artificial hair. The deceased lady grabbed her hair and told her, "How can you walk the street with my hair? You're gonna return my property that you are wearing on your head." My wife just bought this wig, not knowing that it belonged to a deceased woman, who came in her dream to claim her property. Thus many women have hair of deceased people on their head. The world of the dead have power of them. When my wife woke up, she felt like her hair and the wig was burned by acid. Since we pray that morning, she never wore wig anymore. You take your daughter to the saloon to do the hair, but you don't know the spiritual condition of these hairdresser. These wig attract water spirit, and these hairdresser are agent of Satan. Many of them collect your hair. The Lord warned, "You have failed to regret your sin in order to follow me. You continue in habit that I forbade you. You are inclined to do evil and your heart is wicked. I beseech you to return to me your God." Pornography and cursed of nakedness. The Lord showed me the earth and said, "I hold this planet in my hand. I see and know every detail of your action and deeds, brothers." Many are trapped in pornography all their lives. They will not see God, for they are stained and impure. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. The eye is the lamp of the body. If your eyes are good, your whole body will be full of light. But if your eyes are bad, your whole body will be full of darkness. If then the light within you is darkness, how great is that darkness? Your body is the temple of the Spirit. Therefore understand that you are not free to do what you want. As you watch pornography, you are cursed. It is forbidden to see someone nakedness. Many have lost the presence and glory of God because of sin. Brother, arrange your spiritual condition. Times is evil. You don't know the time the Lord will come. and death can surprise you. Today, sport and football are tools of sleep program. The Lord also revealed that many pastor and servant are attached to football and sport, but the Lord told me things like sport and football are invention of Satan. They are things that the devil has made available to maintain humanity in distraction and asleep. Sport is part of the structure of control and manipulation. Fan of football are not entering the kingdom of heaven. You cannot be attached and committed to sport and make it to heaven. And this sport belong to the devil. Football, wrestling and others sport serve to deviate people focus away from the presence of the Lord. And the devil is winning soul through television. Watching naked picture of people is forbidden and is a curse. These images are doorway through which demon enter in people lives in order to kill, steal and destroy. The devil is always planning destruction against God children. The Lord showed me that every part and members of the body have specific sin. There is the sin of the feet, the sin of the hand, the sin of the eyes, the sin of the ears, the sin of the mouth and so on. Sin and premature death. The Lord said, "Go tell my people to return to me." Many of them have went out of my presence. They were praying and serving me, but they went back to the world. Time is grave for humanity. Iniquity has increased. People are not aging, they are dying younger instead of getting old. Even children and youngsters are dying prematurely. This is because sin and wickedness has reached unprecedented level. Evil is rising. The sin of the people are shortening their lives. In the days of Noah, sin had increased on the earth and people went away from the Lord's presence, for the children of God brought wickedness, worldly adornment and murder. As a result, the world of Noah was destroyed. The flood, the Lord said, the wickedness brought by fallen angels is exactly what you see today in the world. It is increasing. The abomination of the days of Noah is here, and the prophet predicted, when you see this abomination in the holy place, we must be careful. The Lord is about to come. When you preachers and singers that stand in the holy place keep dwelling in defilement, my wrath is about to fall. These leaders that stand in holy place have resorted to Satanism because of the love of money and notoriety. The spirit of fame has invaded the church and my people are seeking popularity, yet they are unwilling to pay the price of fasting, sacrifice and prayer. I want them to live in my fear, to walk in holiness, purifying themselves. I want them to separate from the world and its contamination. These are the principles I want. They must commit to keep my words. If my people walk every day sanctifying themselves, increasing their purity and holiness, whatever they say will happen. Whatever they asked will be given to them and their prayer will be answered. They will see my goodness. They will seek me and find me. They will invoke me and I will come down. When you live holy every day, you are gradually rising level in the spirit world. The more you walk in holiness, the more you become great in the unseen world. False prophet, many servants want to become stars, famous and be known. Many of my people have lost connection and contact with me. They lost the oil of the anointing like King Saul, that was ruling without oil. Many are speaking in my name and they are making a lot of noises, but they have lost the oil of my spirit. The Lord said, those who please me and do my will are few. Countless leaders are in black magic, initiation and strange power. The Lord then transported me in the city, showing me many churches in the capital, where leaders have signed pact with demon. Because of the thing of this world, they have joined the enemy. Then I saw a pastor in a meeting with many other leaders, especially young pastor. He was exhorting them to join him in black magic to get more money and many members. I saw many that agreed to join him and they receive power. I saw a lot of young servant joining him, and I cry a lot seeing this. The Lord said, many are not serving me. My true servant exist, but they are few. People don't know them, for they are not in the media. Many of them have not built churches. They are still winning soul. They are missionary. They are not interested in popularity and fame. They walk in my fear and in simplicity. I saw that these true servants were dressed in white garment. They were holding sword in their hand. The Lord said, these swords are my word, for they are preaching sound doctrines. I have crowns reserved for those who will preach sound doctrine. They will go through persecution because of biblical gospel. The crown is for those who have passion for lost souls. These are my true servant. They preach the truth that hurt and they talk about sin that is among the people, to lead them to regret and repentance. I remember a brother that called me on the phone and said, told me, this doctrine of holiness of the body, which is against makeup, adornment and wig, is something new to us. People won't listen to you, because they have been taught another kind of teaching. I said, women who love God will be willing to renounce all, including themselves. They will definitely be willing to abandon worldly adornment. If you really love the Lord, you will renounce and deny yourself. You will take up your cross and follow the Lord. Seek the kingdom of heaven first. You must seek to enter heaven. You cannot have your eyes on the things of the earth and lose your soul in the place of torment, where I saw many pastor. One of them used to have a TV channel in the city center. I saw him in the flame of hell. He was in torment. I remember before his death, the Lord sent me to warn him to repent, for his time was short. I went to see him with a CD of my testimony, but he refused to receive me, telling me he is not interested. 1 week after that refusal, he died. He said, go tell people to stop worshipping me. I took the glory of God. Then I saw another pastor who also used satanic power for miracle. The Lord showed me when he was born again. On that day I saw bright angels celebrating his coming to the Lord with music and trumpet. Over time this pastor adopted the material gospel of prosperity. As the love of money grew in his heart, he was initiated in strange power of darkness. The pastor told me, the Lord called me to serve him. I deviated, joining initiation in dark power, to become famous and wealthy. But this is my fate in this place of torment, where fire was lava, a volcano. Lost souls were helpless and they were screaming. It was terror. The pastor was in the flame. Many people know him. It is time now to seek the Lord, for he is available and willing to erase all our sin. You just need to repent. The Lord said many pastors must repent. They deviated people, removing them from my presence. They have preached what my spirit did not indicate to them. They only show them, the people, the pleasure and good things of this terrestrial world. Your mission is to preach the inhabitant of the earth the kingdom of heaven. Get people eyes to the things of heaven. I want my people to look at eternal things, that is incorruptible. My dear, can you count the number of people that are already dead, especially from this sickness that is striking the world? The Lord said, tell my servant, this year 2021 is about evangelism. I remember when I saw the missionary T.L. Osborne in heaven. There were many radiant angels with him. The Lord said, do you want to know why Tommy Osborne made it to heaven? He was attached to the truth and he was a soul winner. All his life he went to save souls. The Lord like evangelism when God people invade the territory to grab souls from the enemy and lead them to him, and the Lord will respond to your need. Make the Lord your priority. Win souls.